When I met Frank, he was curious, he was confident, he was anxious, but at the same time, he had a high chest and a strong chin to just look strong and be strong for his family at the same time.
I have a new norm. That's what my wife keeps telling me, and my friends tell me, you got it, my family, you got a new norm, you got to learn to live, you know, with a little restriction. But I guess it's better than the other alternative, you know, and it is better. I was told that you could be paralyzed, you could not talk again. That would kill me not talking, I love to talk. And everything ended with possibly death. I was worried about my family, I worried about my wife. I straightened everything out and wrote everything down that she would have to do if something happened.
Frank's case is a very interesting and unique case. Its incidence is about 0.1 to every 100,000, so almost quite literally one in a million. From an imaging standpoint, it had very similar characteristics of a tumor we call a chordoma.
He showed us like a model of what it would look like. He said, that's what you have. I know it, I've seen it before.
When we print one of these models, they get an idea of the real life size of whatever the pathology is.
My wife said I almost like gave him an interview when I asked him 1,000 questions, you know. And she said, the poor guy, and I was asking him everything and anything, you know, and he came up with answers, you know. And he said, I don't care, I'll take whatever questions you want, you know. And he answered me.
He understood. He understood in the heart. And part of healing is no stress of having to be aggravated or frustrated with a doctor. Part of the healing is having someone say, got it, don't worry.
This is his spine. This is the back of his spine. This is the front of his spine. All this purple is the tumor. There are many risks to this procedure. Clearly, there's big blood vessels, and there's a lot of nerves attached to this, and esophagus and the trachea are also there. So any of those things are affected in a negative way. They can lead to very devastating, catastrophic events. But with this 3D planning and the expertise and the equipment and the technology we have to offer, it really helped us avoid all those issues. I think, truthfully, the type of tumor he had, there's only a handful of institutions across the country that can take care of these types of pathologies. They have to be a very specialized institution who deal with these tumors, who have trained under folks who have done hundreds of these cases. To be able to offer a type of surgery we offered Frank and many others is a privilege for us as providers, but also to the community.
There's little things that he did. Made sure my wife, every 2 hours, was told what's going on with me in the surgery room. It was 19 hours.
Even afterwards, he came out and talked to us, and like my daughters and I, and he sat down and just spoke with us. He sat down in the cafeteria with us, and he really did make it a whole lot easier.
Dr. Konakondla is just, he's like family. He really is right now, you know. I can't explain how important he is to me. What's the chances of him being there, this man that is gonna know what I have, which is one in a million. So what's the chances of that? Think about it. God put him there, you know, and thank God he was there. Geisinger, I'm very happy for them that they had him, and I'm happy for myself that they had him, you know, and he actually saved my life. That's how I feel.
Frank's grandkids gave me these little cards, which I still keep in my office. Dear Dr. K, thanks for helping Pap. This is supposed to be me, so I think it's pretty accurate. But it's a very friendly reminder that we really do some cool stuff for people sometimes.